language signing in bring you what is 100% authentic and can never be manufactured? Yeah, you guys. Oh, well, I'm going to kind of make this video kind of short as I'm running. I kind of have a time restraint. But anyways, I went to go see All Eyes on Me, like I said, from the last video. I definitely wanted to check it out, not only that, because, you know, I'm a huge Tupac fan. I grew up, was born in the 90s. I remember a lot of his songs coming out while I was probably like 7, 8 years old. I kind of got the tail end. But anyways, there's even some instances where, you know, you watched me, but that's some other story. But I also wanted to check out and see how my uncle did. My uncle got to play himself in the movie. But yeah, I was very proud to see, you know, how that production came out. And I know there was a lot of controversy with, you know, certain people not liking the movie. But I thought, like any other movie, like a biopic pick, it wasn't going to focus too much, as it was 2 hours. And you can't possibly put in every single thing, because this man accomplished so much under 25 years of his life. I mean, there's just so much that I think you couldn't possibly cover that in 2 hours. So as far as, you know, saying as far as there was more, there's things missing, I mean, yeah, that's sure. I would have loved to personally see them shooting the Hit 'Em Up video, but I mean, they did show, you know, I Get Around, you know, which is my uncle's song. But I mean, I think for the most part, Demetrius did pretty well. You know, he did very well portraying, you know, Tupac. And I just thought that it was very well put together. The young man that looked like Shock G, I actually got a chance when I was with my aunt visiting my uncle, going to the studio to record the music for this, you know, for the movie. The young man looked so much like Shock G. It was crazy. I was just like, wow, in person. I was like, they found the right person to pick him to play Shock G. But, I mean, he's just so humble. He was very nice, kind of quiet, but it's interesting when you see people on TV, you know, when they portray some, you know, a character, you see them in person, they're so different, but he definitely had the look of Shock G, and from what I heard, you know, essence, even some personality traits of Shock G. Shock G could be kind of out there, but he's a little bit to himself and shy, and these are multiple occurrences. But I want to say I probably give the movie probably out of 5, make a 4.5, because I just thought that they chronicalized. I mean, granted, some of the stuff we already knew about Tupac, I mean, I wanted to learn a little bit more, something new, but I just thought it was really put together. Just chronicalizing him as, you know, being, you know, his mother being a Black Panther, how he came to be, you know, poetic, what he wanted to do, change the world. And mind you, you know, a lot of the All Eyes on Me is based on his documentary, you know, him being interviewed in jail at the time, I guess, for the rape of this young woman. You know, it was alleged that he raped this woman, but, you know, either way, he was in jail being interviewed for it. So, this is based on that story of his life, talking about how, you know, he came to be Tupac, what we know, the great poet, the great, you know, oh my God, the philosopher, kind of getting us woke, you know, in the early stages of consciousness. And it was just crazy the amount of stuff he went through. I mean, when I think about people who I can kind of see being infamous like Tupac as far as court cases and jails. A lot of these rappers, and one comes to mind, R&B artist Chris Brown. You know, he kind of gets that rep as being like kind of that bad, and that's what Tupac was like, kind of like a just a notorious bad boy in a sense. But yeah, I just, my heart goes out. Benny Boone did a good job, and I just want to challenge you to see it at least once, you know, or see it when it comes, whatever. I mean, I don't go by what people say, and just because a huge number of people, and specifically celebrities, people tend to want to listen to celebrities, but fuck that. Like, I've been around celebrities all my life. I've been, you know, they're all people. They bleed just like me and you. We all bleed. I don't go by other people's opinions, because at the end of the day, the only opinion that matters is mine, you know? So we're just gonna get out that, you know, that following mentality, starstruck thing where we just only value celebrities' opinions. Value your own opinion, formulate your own opinions and what you think. But yeah, anyways, that's that. I really enjoyed the Tupac movie, All Eyes on Me, and definitely had to support my uncle. Like I said, I was going to go to the premiere, but for other reasons, I did not go to the premiere. But I got to see it over the weekend. And also, the same day I got to see it was the BET Awards, and that's what I want to kind of transition to. The BET Awards, I thought Leslie Jones did, I mean, she was very over the top in the beginning. Just, oh my God, I was just like, how could someone have that so much energy and just drag it that long? But I think Miss Jones did a pretty good job hosting. I think she definitely lived up to the fact that it was going to be one of the best shows. She's going to take care, and she got a little bit retarded and silly throughout the whole show, but I just thought, as far as performances, now I'm always going to support the BET Awards, because the BET Awards is one of the only things, I mean, granted, BET is not fully BET anymore, but if you know what I mean, who bought it now, but it's like one of the only platforms that we have as our own, and it's the Black community that represents Black, African, you know, just Blackness, Black culture, Black music, something of our own platform, and awards that recognize our artists and our great achievements that we do. And I'm always going to support the BET Awards, and if I get a chance to go and be invited every year, I'm always going to attend, because I just feel like that's so much better than any Grammy, whatever, Golden Globes, whatever. I'm always going to support that, because the Tonys, whatever, the Emmys, the Grammys, what's that Broadway one? I guess it doesn't matter, because I don't really care for it. But that one where you win things in your acting, you know, career for being recognized, and they hardly recognize us, especially when there's 100% raw talent coming from the Black community, so... Whatever, the Oscars, yeah, there you go, the Oscars. I mean, I care about what's accurately recognized, and I'm always going to recognize. I've always watched BET Awards, and it was just good to see, you know, first of all, Bruno Mars, who was one of the winners. He won Best Male R&B Artist, Video of the Year, and I believe there was one more, but he kicked ass in the beginning. That boy can dance. That man can dance. He can break down, pop, lock it, whatever, like old school. Like, he's like a modern day, I guess, everyone stems, I guess, from James Brown to Michael Jackson to Elvis, like, and then Bruno Mars. It's like that, he definitely comes down that line, and he broke it down. I just thought it was good, you know, for best group, we're talking the Migos. Migos won, and rightfully so. They have a lot of collaborations, had a lot of hits this year, and they definitely deserved best group. For best actress, Taraji P. Henson won. And also the movie that Taraji P. was in, Hidden Figures, won for best movie. That's a little bit background that wasn't acknowledged into the program, but I just thought I'd bring that up. As far as video of the year, best female R&B pop artist, and album of the year, whoever. Y'all know who already won that. Hands down, Beyonce, Lemonade, Lemonade, Lemonade. Sorry, okay? And side note, if you're not aware, her and her twins are released now doing well at home. So I'm looking forward to figuring out if my theory of them being girls is true. I heard they may be boy and girl, but we'll see. We'll see, you guys. So, I also want to point out a huge one. Not only did Beyonce, but Solange won for Best Centric Award for Cranes in the Sky, and rightfully so. That was a very good, once again, a just awakening, conscious, just album, just beautiful, beautiful representation. And talking about, us, don't touch my hair, FUBU. That's where I got, my idea back again for FUBU, my FUBU series. But, definitely the Knowles sisters are definitely winning. And it was just good to see them recognized, as well as Bruno Mars, Remy Ma, Chance the Rapper for Best New Rapper, as well as a humanitarian. He was honored for the humanitarian award, and that brother's doing a lot of stuff, a lot of good things in Chicago. And I just want to mention, I'm going to do another video in the future pointing out. I know I don't like to focus on celebrities, like once again, like there are no people, unless they're doing stuff that's significant to the world and the community. And this brother made a beautiful speech, very much like Jesse Williams last year. But he said, fuck the court, this court system, letting people go and not having justice. I heard God, a lot of people were praising God at the end. God's justice is truly divine. Maxwell having a song, you play the game of gods, and I thought that was a significant thing. These people are playing the game like they're gods, and they're not God. They're gonna have to answer to God for this, for these crimes and exonerations and just no justice. And but I just want to say, Chance the Rapper, he really did his thing with this speech, saying, and he wants to help the world. I think that is someone, a celebrity, if I'm gonna follow a celebrity, that's worth following to me, because he's about helping the community, his community, Chicago. Not only that, repairing this world, and no one man can do that, granted, but I can tell he's in for it. He's in to try to make the world a better place. And I feel like if you are anyone of a platform, it's definitely a big thing to use your platform to be able to help the greater masses. And if I ever become a high official or have a platform one day, I definitely, that's what I'm gonna use my platform for, just to help the world. I'm a humanitarian myself, and for all those humanitarians, activists out there, anything that you stand for the common good, the good of the world, the good of people, go fight for it. Why we gave us God gave us life for a reason, gave us a purpose, and I believe our purpose is to help each other, or come together and communicate in ways in which we've never communicated before, and try to make a difference. I just don't see any more value to life than that. But definitely, kudos to Serena Williams and Steph Curry for both for Sportsmen and Women of the Year. And I just really thoroughly enjoyed the BET Awards late at night, because I got off of work really late. So I I just really enjoy Leslie Jones did her thing, performance wise. Oh, it was very good seeing Tamar Braxton just, she threw it down. Like, I know there was memes prior years to her, how she was singing, I guess with her eyes bulging, but that is, I don't care about that, but she really did hold it together and did her thing, broke that down. Like, you can tell it was coming from the pits of her soul singing that song. She looked great as well. And I was just so amazed at her performance, the tribute. And for Best Lifetime Achievement Award, oh, New Edition, broke it down, kind of brought me down to my childhood. Like, my parents, you know, kudos to my parents for introducing me in the early 90s, and, you know, and thus far, and continuing to real music, music that meant things, you know, music that send a message, you know. New Edition, I definitely, that they're part of my childhood growing up, listening to the music, my parents introducing them to their music and listening to them. Bobby Brown, I mean, the tribute, the characters who played them in the movie, their movie that they had this year, tribute them. And, you know, I think Luke James, and I think his name is Luke James, but just, they just brought it down. Of course, that tribute was phenomenal. What else? Chris Brown did his thing. Big Sean, of course. Seeing Escape reunited on the stage, I mean, that was priceless. Beautiful, you know, to see them all. Tiny, Candy, you know, all of them, you know, breaking it down, and all four of them. And that was just a sight to see. What else? I mean, there's so many. Oh, SZA. I can't, fine ass SZA. Man, I'm telling you, SZA was looking good. Look, she was looking good. I mean, whew, damn. I listen, I have a new female crush. Female celebrity crush, but she definitely did her thing. Beautiful woman, a new age type of artist, new kind of a flow music, and just beautiful. I could tell her spirit's beautiful just looking at her perform. It was beautiful. Oh my God, that the BET Awards was good. It definitely wasn't. It seems like it's gotten a lot better since Michael Jackson passed and they honored him that year. But I definitely say the BET Awards this year was good. I just had a good weekend celebrating, seeing our accomplishments, seeing, you know, people being recognized that normally wouldn't be recognized on these other TV shows, you know, award shows. And I just thought it was beautiful, just beautiful seeing just Black Magic, man. Black Magic. You know, granted, I'm talking about Black Magic today. So, well, anyways, you guys, once again, LH, about to sign out. Remember, stay true to thyself, peace and love, and remember, nothing real, 100%, can ever be threatened, you guys, all right? So, yeah, I want you to continue to live your lives, see the Tupac movie, and peace out. Have a good rest of the week. It's Monday. Make this week productive in the last week of June. All right. Peace and love. Checking out.